Guests across Europe will hear today that they've won a battle with EC bureaucrats over safety. Breakfast News has learnt that a new European directive designed to protect steam train drivers from burns has been dropped. Preservation societies had argued that the changes to engine cab design would destroy more than a century of railway heritage.
With over 150 years of tradition under threat, it's little wonder Britain's vintage locomotives have been raising a real head of steam over Brussels bureaucracy. Instead of rediscovering the golden age of steam, millions of railway enthusiasts across Europe faced witnessing their favourite engines being unceremoniously derailed. Under the Hot Services Directive, the railways would have been forced to lag or insulate all the steam pipes, boilers and valves to protect the health and safety of their drivers and firemen, and paint all obtruding objects fluorescent yellow. Drivers like Bob Bain say that way they couldn't have operated.
For years now, engine drivers have used an oily rag, and that's our best insulation yet. If you wear gloves, they get hot, but if you wear a rag, you can fold it over and make twice as thick, and that's twice the insulation. The fire hall door reaches a temperature of about 1,000 degrees centigrade, and the paint hasn't been invented what will stick to that.
Preservation Society railways across Europe carried 9 million passengers last year. Those enjoying the delights of North Norfolk's Poppy Line had their own views on what they saw as Brussels interference.
I can't see why they ran railways like this for years and years and they never killed themselves or burnt themselves then. Why should they do it now?
You can't tell children about steam trains and then not have any steam.
You think it's marvellous, don't you, Gina? Do you enjoy the trains?
Sentiments which helped Europe's steam railway aficionados, headed by a London lawyer, to get the European Commission to grant an exclusion clause for preservation societies.
People in ivory towers are making rules and regulations without any idea of what it's like on the ground. And I hope that if people go and visit steam railways in their own part of the world, they will see the sort of job that we've been doing, and I have to say, very safely, for a very long period of time.
Next time, the railways say they'll be more prepared, just in case Brussels returns with a vengeance.
They may come out with some new things like boilers. Are we going to have to paint them in all sorts of gaudy colours just to prove that there's some safety factor in it? I think they've got to consult us first, and that would help a lot.
For now, though, Britain's steam railways are celebrating a famous victory. Quite simply, they've blown the whistle on Brussels. Bill Hamilton, BBC News, on the Poppy Line.